Jamaican cuisine is truly a melting pot. Combining Spanish, African, Indian, and Chinese roots and spices, their food has stewed up a multitude of lively flavors, quite notably their jerk seasoning. A lot of allspice, a ton of tamarind, and of course, those Scotch bonnet peppers. I'm heading to Midtown Manhattan to a street cart where a husband and wife team are slinging amazing jerk seasoned meats, as well as adding a little bit of Americana to the mix. I can't wait to try it. Hey, I am on 35th Street and Broadway. I am here in front of Island Spice Grill with Roxanne.
Yes.
Tell me all about this place, because I got a text message from a friend with a photograph of about 150 people in line.
Mm-hmm.
And she was like, you have to check this place out. So tell me all about this place.
Every day we're serving up jerk chicken, jerk pork. We have lemon pepper brisket. You know, people love the food. They come sometimes just for one thing and they leave with a combination, sometimes a little bit of everything. The meat starts cooking about 5 a.m.
Okay.
But preparation starts about 48 hours before that, when we're putting in our seasonings and we're doing our sauces, which my husband loves to do his sauces. It's all natural and he grinds everything up. I can't tell you what.
What kind of peppers? Can you tell me that at least?
Of course, you have to have the Scotch bonnet
okay,
in there.
Okay, so it is real,
it's
the real
Scotch
deal.
Bonnet, the real
do you
deal.
Have trouble getting the right, the really, the right Scotch
honestly,
bonnet?
Honestly, we don't have that much trouble with the Scotch bonnet. If you go to like a lot of our local places, we're able to get nice, ripe, hot peppers.
Okay, so you get the, you get the heat in this,
we
right?
get the heat, yes. We got the heat. We want to be everywhere so everybody can get a little bit of that Caribbean feel, you know?
Right.
We want the tropics, we want the Caribbean, we want the Bob Marley, we want the smoke, we want it all. Every day, even when it's cold, we want people to still enjoy and feel like they're in the tropics.
How much do you go through in a day?
Man, it's so much food that we serve. Well, this machine right here in particular is equipped to serve, to carry 700 pounds of meat at one time.
Okay. So what's the most popular meat?
They're all pretty popular, but the jerk chicken is our signature, you know, because, you know, jerk chicken is very,
it's what everyone knows.
It's what everyone knows. You understand? Normally, we usually sell out in 3 to 4 hours.
You do specials, right? Like the brisket.
Right.
And...
right. I do briskets. Sometimes I do lamb. I do jerk chicken. Sometimes on Fridays, I do fish Fridays. I do the fish.
Okay, here we go. I'm gonna get stuck in here. I'm gonna start with the dark meat because that's usually where I begin and end when it comes to chicken, frankly. Wow, this is very tender. This is really fall apart. I mean, this is like, it's like the finest barbecue. Mmm, wow. Serious smoke penetration. That's the first thing that really hits you, but then there's that gentle warmth that comes on, the jerk seasoning. And now it's sort of building to a crescendo, and it's pretty hot, it's nice. You can definitely tell the Scotch bonnet's in there. The high Scoville factor. And you can see it's got a nice, real pink color to it. That's something you really wouldn't get in an oven at home. Okay, next I'm going in for the pork. Wow, look at the skin on that. Again, we have the same traits as barbecue, which is not surprising because this is long smoked pork. So you have the smoke ring, and then you have these, you can see the pork just falls into these tender long ribbons. Definitely a cousin to barbecue, but the flavor profile is so different because of the jerk rub. It's vibrant, spicy. It's got like a tang, you know, like a tang to it that you don't have with traditional American barbecue. This is really delicious. So I'm gonna actually make myself a little mini sandwich here with all these little scraps of pork. Which I'm gonna soak. Mmm. Compared to Wonder Bread, this is like much more robust. You can see it's really quite dense, spongy, almost like a yoga mat, but much tastier. Like Subway bread has yoga mat in it. This doesn't, but it has the properties of a yoga mat. Okay, well, I'll say this much. These lines are fully justified. This is fantastic, evocative food. We have a mix of people and flavors and cultures all coming together and eating this melting pot food. So if you're in New York City, look for Island Spice Grill on social media, and you can find me on the next episode of The Meat Show by clicking right here. We have the whiskey-aged steak.
The sense of the dry-aged beef, this like sort of sweet, funky smell just emanates. It's such a powerful aroma
it's
in
so
the best possible way.
Right.